Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your boy Kenny, and this is the Oscars 2017 review. Man, let me go to say that this was actually a pretty good show this year. I can honestly say that you can definitely tell that there's been a lot of changes to the Academy and how the way they presented. I mean, it was pretty much reminiscent of the diversity we saw at the Emmys and the Golden Globes, where it's become more inclusive. Now at the end of the day, I'm not saying that, everything is all great, but I can say you can definitely see that there has been some progression. It's more diverse, and it's definitely more appealing to a youthful audience. And I can definitely say that this is a major upgrade from last year. Now, this doesn't mean that, everything is okay or that everything is solved, but I can honestly say with this show, I can see that the Academy Award is definitely making some progress, and I applaud it, because definitely we not only saw progress in the actual crowd in the attendance of the Academy Awards this year, but we definitely also saw it in the winners. Definitely some of the highlights for me was Mahershala Ali winning Best Supporting Actor for Moonlight. Moonlight is an independent film, and Moonlight really did its thing this year. And another highlight for me was my girl, Viola Davis, from How to Get Away with Murder. I also reviewed that show as well, and definitely check me out on that. But I'm so happy that she won Best Supporting Actress for Fences. She looked amazing in her red gown, and she gave a great acceptance speech. And she pretty much just dedicated it to telling the stories of real, actual people and bringing people's stories to life. And I thought that was a very beautiful, beautiful acceptance speech that she did. And it just really shows the humbleness and the, vivaciousness that Viola Davis represents. And it was beautiful to see. Also, another big win tonight was for Moonlight. They won Best Adapted Screenplay, which was awarded to Barry Jenkins, who was also the director, and also Terrell Alvin McCraney. And they had a great acceptance speech, that they dedicate this to all of the black and brown and yellow children who feel, disenfranchised or don't feel accepted or feel misunderstood, that this is a movie for you that regardless of where you come from, you can prevail and you can actually, survive and succeed. So it was great that, the whole story of Moonlight is actually encouraging to a lot of people who may be battling with not just your sexuality, but battling your race or battling poverty or battling, personal circumstances. And you actually rise above those circumstances. But even though you're going through those hard times, you have this inner strength to keep going. So I thought that was pretty, pretty profound that they dedicated it to that they actually dedicated it to people like even people like myself, people who have, been put in that category of, being not good enough or feeling like, you don't fit in and you don't belong. This is a film to let you know that regardless of what society may say, you do matter and you are golden regardless. So that was beautiful. And also a big win for me tonight, also for Moonlight, was that they won Best Picture. Now I have to say congratulations to Barry Jenkins and the whole creative team behind Moonlight, because this was an independent movie that has now captured the heart of America and now has won one of the top, categories of the show. And I was actually really happy that that Moonlight took the Oscar home. They even made a joke where they said it was La La Land, playing off of what Steve Harvey did with the Miss Universe pageant. And it turns out really the real winner was Moonlight. And it was great seeing the whole cast up there, seeing black excellence and black talent represented in the highest form. I mean, that was very groundbreaking. And it was groundbreaking for the fact that, you know, Moonlight being an independent movie has now crossed over into mainstream in a big way, and it's actually making huge stars out of all the cast that was a part of it. I mean, I remember Tashawn Rose when he played the role of Ramsey on If Loving You Is Wrong, and now he's in one of the top movies of the country. I mean, talk about an upgrade. And also Janelle Monáe and Naomi Harris, who was also nominated for Best Supporting Actress. You know, Mahershala Ali, who's won Best Supporting Actor tonight. I mean, this was a really groundbreaking movie, and, you know, I haven't seen it yet, but I look forward to seeing it, and I'm actually going to buy it on DVD. So, yeah. Once I do, I will definitely review it, you know, because I would definitely want to pay homage to this great work. Also, to talk about the overall tone of the show, I actually liked it. I mean, it was a very diverse crowd. It was very easygoing. I think Jimmy Kimmel did a great job hosting. I liked how he had candy coming from the sky like two or three times. I thought that was pretty cool. And another thing that really struck me, too, was how he paid homage to Meryl Streep, because we definitely remember, I think when Meryl Streep won her Golden Globe, she spoke out against Donald Trump, and then Donald Trump kind of clapped back on her on Twitter, saying that she's a has-been and she's irrelevant, but yet she was nominated for a Best Actress Oscar tonight, and she's highly respected by the Hollywood elites, but she's a has-been and she's irrelevant. Really, Donald Trump? But then I also like the fact that Jimmy Kimmel played around with the whole texting Donald Trump, and he texted that Meryl Streep says hi. I thought that was pretty funny. And also, I think another thing that stood out about the show was that they actually had a tour bus of actual tourists who actually came into the Oscars not knowing that they were coming to the Oscars, and they kind of surprised them, and you literally saw just these regular citizens who were literally taking a tour and actually were able to meet some of their favorite Hollywood celebrities right there at the Academy Awards. And it was great because we saw the actual celebrities, you know, be humbled and was actually proud to meet some of their fans, you know, right there at the Oscars. And it was great because you actually saw the fans as well as the stars kind of like coming together. And I thought that was very profound. And it was great. I mean, they were meeting with Denzel Washington, Halle Berry, Meryl Streep, Emma Stone. I mean, everybody that was up there, you know, they got to touch Mahershala Ali's Oscar, you know, they got to, you know, rub the gold. So I thought it was pretty cool. And it was good because it really kind of, you know, was like really hitting home that the Oscars need to change. And I hope that this progression continues, that this is just not a one-time thing. Okay, we did this, but we're going to go back to the way things were. No, the hell with that. You know, keep moving forward. Make it more diverse. You know, make it more youthful. You know, make it more appealing, you know, to different audiences, you know, where people of all race and all creeds and also sexual orientation can come together and can celebrate, you know, art, music, you know, the pretty much the arts, you know, the movies, the you know, the music, the sciences that goes behind it, as well as the technology. I mean, this was actually a really groundbreaking show. And I hope it actually goes in this direction. I mean, now that the Oscars have a new president, and she also spoke as well, and she spoke on the fact that, you know, that magic is universal, and that's what we have to show. You know, it can't be about, you know, race and, you know, pretty much segregation and all of that crap. You know, that's got to be out the window, you know, because you can get magic from anywhere from around the world, and we have to award that, and we can no longer disenfranchise anybody. So I thought that was very profound that she, you know, stood up and actually talked about that. And I can honestly say I actually enjoyed the Oscars. I've watched the Oscars, you know, throughout my life. I mean, especially in my teens, because I was a really big Hollywood buff when I was a teenager. But I never really saw it this I never really was actually moved by the Oscars. Usually I'm bored by the Oscars, but this year I was actually rather entertained and rather intrigued. And I liked the fact that it was different. I liked the fact that it was more appealing, that it wasn't so stuffed shirt and so boring. They actually made it interesting. They actually made it entertaining. And I liked the fact that the stars, they were very humbled and were more at ease. And it was also great seeing some other stars, and there was also some great fashions that I loved. I mean, I could say that Emma Stone really looked great in her Givenchy. I mean, she really rocked that French dress. And she also won Best Actress, so congratulations to her. Also, Casey Affleck, I mean, he had the rugged look because he's actually working on the film, but he won Best Actor. And, kudos to him as well. So, and also, I also love the fact that, Jimmy Kimmel really just had fun. You know, he really was just having a good time. I mean, especially the jabs he was taking at Matt Damon, because, him and Matt Damon are very good friends. He just kept messing with Matt Damon throughout the whole show, and I thought that was so funny. So I thought that there were some good highlights of the show. And then, I mean, as far as fashions, definitely I said about Emma Stone. Viola Davis looked beautiful in her red gown. Taraji P. Henson looked amazing. Octavia Spencer looked great. Janelle Monáe looked amazing as well. And definitely futuristic with her look. I loved it. Let's see. Who else? Nicole Kidman looked amazing as well. Salma Hayek looked great. Halle Berry looked great in her dress too. I mean, she was rocking, the Whitney Houston wig, so she was definitely doing her thing. And Halle Berry looked amazing. I loved the dress. Naomi Harris looked amazing as well. Definitely loved the shoes. But that's pretty much my take. But if there's anything you guys noticed, put it down in the comments. I'd definitely like to hear from you guys. But I really did enjoy this show, and I really hope that the Oscars continues on this path, because this is actually a good path. And if I'm reviewing the Oscars, that's letting you know something, that there was definitely a shift, in the presentation, as well as the inclusion of all races and all stories. So I was actually really proud of this year's presentation. So I'll just go on to say that I thoroughly enjoyed it. But that's what I have for you guys. If anything you guys want to talk about, put it down in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. But subscribe to my channel. Click that bell so you can get notifications every time I drop a video. Like this video, share this video, comment on this video. And it's been a pleasure viewing the Oscars. And I hope that they continue on this pathway in the future. So that's what I got for you guys. So until next time, take care.